Cowabunga dudes, this is Anthony, aka BatBomb82, and welcome to another episode of Totally Tubular Turtle Tuesday, the one day of the week where I devote my channel to something TMNT related, from action figures to comic books to video games and movies, and everything in between. So for this episode, I'll be taking a look at the Tales of the Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles, Samurai Turtles, with Usagi Yojimbo. Now, taking a look at the front, we can see that all five figures are showcased on the new blister card packaging, with the Tales of the Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtle blurb at the top. Turning one of the cards around, we can see images of some of the figures from this lineup, including the standard Usagi from this wave. So with the packaging out of the way, let's crack these figures open and see what we have inside. And here are the samurais out of the packaging. And man, I am absolutely loving these turtles. These are probably some of the best turtle figures from the modern TMNT line. I love their samurai armor, the colors look great, and this is a really cool Usagi figure that I have been waiting for a very long time. So what are we waiting for? Let's take a closer look at the Samurai Turtles with Usagi Yojimbo. Alright guys, now let's take a closer look at the Samurai Turtles with Usagi Yojimbo. Now this is a set I've actually been waiting for a very long time. I've always been a real big fan of the turtles in samurai armor, and these are pretty awesome. One thing I will note, the turtles themselves are all the exact same height. Which isn't accurate to the show because they're all different heights. But because for the figures, they use the exact same body molds. The only difference really going to be the paint, the faces themselves, so the head sculpts, and the helmets. But everything looks pretty cool, so let's check them out. Let's start off with Mikey here. Mikey is pretty awesome. I do love this quite a bit. As you can see, the armor looks really good. Lots of sculpted detail in here with like floral patterns and whatnot. Lots of cool stuff. You can see the bottom of the feet have the sandals and whatnot. The shell is like covered really cool. The helmet looks great. As you can see, Mikey has these like almost like scythe or kunais. I forget what they're called. Not kunais. I forget what they're called. Type weapons, but with like a little spike ball and chain on the end, which is really cool. So I like that quite a bit. The way the helmets work, the mask just slides off like that. You can pull it off and they all have the exact same identical like dragon type mask. The only real difference is going to be the color. Then the helmets themselves are different, so they all each have their own little crown piece right there. And these just pop off like that. And these are actually the same head sculpts we got with the original Nickelodeon TMNT figures. The only difference is the bandana, because the bandana drapes down like that. So the helmet can fit over them like that. So pretty cool. I do like that one quite a bit. Let's take a look at Leo, which is my favorite turtle. Pretty cool. Same thing. Same exact design, except in the blue. He gets this really wicked, like, you know, almost like a shredder type of sword, which looks pretty awesome. Like I said, all the exact same thing. Really nice sculpt and whatnot. It's got a different type of crown for the on the helmet. Got the blue dragon mask. Pull that off. And you can see the exact same face that we got with the original figure, except just with a draped over... Draped down, bandana, which is pretty cool. I do love this sword. Yeah, I think it's such a cool look. I love this figure so much. Let's move on to Raphael. Again, exact same figure. Pretty cool. He gets these like, these are kind of like almost like size and whatnot, but I feel like these blades on the cartoon, these are like a straight blade and these blades are gonna like pop open on one of the sides. And he has this little tassel with whatever this little ring is or whatnot. I think those are pretty cool too. I really like the way this one looks with the red. He's got a different crown like that. Same thing, pop off the helmet like so. Got the similar helmet, or excuse me, the same head that we got with the original figure. Pop off the mask like that. It looks very cool. I love these dragon masks. I think they're very awesome looking, very tough and mean and fierce. I am so glad I got these figures. I'm so glad I picked them all up in hand at the same time, even with Usagi, because I think these are really awesome. Now with Donnie. Donnie, I think, is probably my favorite one of the four turtles. I just think the color purple looks really good with this samurai armor. Love the purple dragon mask, the different crown, these will point more straight up. And I love his weapon. It's like this big wooden staff thing. You can get two-handed poses with it, but all these spikes and whatnot. I think that's very, very cool. I love this quite a bit. Same thing, you can remove the mask. Ooh, it's a little tight on this one. Like that. And you can pop it off of the helmet just like so. And then there you go. So pretty, pretty cool. So actually, let's take a look at articulation for the turtles with him, because they are the exact same mold. So all the articulation for the turtles themselves are exactly the same. So the head is on a ball joint, does roll around just like that, looks up and down, turns left and right, pivots side to side, arms go all the way up and down, out, rotate at the shoulder, single bend at the elbow, rotation at the elbow, swivel at the wrist, nothing at the waist. The skirt piece is a softer plastic, which is very good, so you can kick forward that much, back about that far, can do the splits about that, kind of rotates in there a little bit, single bend at the knee, rotation at the knee, and then nothing below that. Now you can see all the feet are hollowed out. I'm not sure why they do that, to be honest. I kind of assume it's for it's either for balancing purposes or to save cost on plastic. I honestly have no idea. But Donatello for these Samurai Turtles, I think he's definitely my favorite in this set. So now let's take a look at Usagi, because I think this is one that everybody wants to see. Usagi is definitely a fan favorite amongst the TMNT line, and I think this is awesome. So you can see he has pretty similar armor to what the turtles have, but his is done in almost like a brownish copper, and I think that looks really, really cool too. One thing I will notice is that there lacks paint on the wrists right here. I kind of wish it was that same like copperish gold on the rest of the armor. What I do also notice, excuse me, let's see if I can focus my camera a bit. There you go. The copper on the shoulders is actually a little more metallic than the rest of the armor. I kind of wish it was all that metallic paint. I don't know why they just didn't go that route. So it's a little odd. He also does have these like wrist guards like the other turtles have. But these are just painted white. Again, no color detailing. I wish it would have been some of that copperish gold, but it looks pretty, pretty cool. Got his sandals and his knee pads. This like braces, I don't know what these are. Don't get any paint around the back. Only in the front, you can kind of see where it cuts off. Goes brown and then into the blue with the rest of the pants, so it's okay. His sash right here, his belt, is all done in a metallic gold, which is a little weird, but it's pretty cool. His sheath right here is actually glued to the thing, to the figure itself, so you cannot remove that. But oop, and his helmet just fell off. But he does have two katanas, like so, that he can hold in both hands, just like that. And then let me show you this right here before it fell off. So again, the helmet looks really cool. Same type of dragon mask that we get with the rest of the turtles, but the helmet is a little different because it's shaped to wrap over his head instead of just a standard turtle's head. So you got a different crescent type crown at the top, and you can see Usagi's head. This pulls off as just one piece. The dragon mask piece itself does not separate. It's actually just one whole helmet that you could just put on like that. So I guess you could take it off because it seems like they just glued it in place. So you could take it off, I guess, if you really wanted to. But then you get the standard Usagi head, which is really, really cool. Even has that scar over his eye right there. Pretty, pretty cool. Just classic Usagi. And then you get his ears kind of folding back to kind of drape into the helmet, which is pretty, pretty cool. And then you got his like whiskers kind of thing. Really good sculpt for that. Really nice paint and whatnot. I love that quite a bit. So let me take these off real quick. So let's take a look at articulation with Usagi here. Now the head's on a ball joint, does roll around just like that. Rotates left and right, looks up and down, pivots side to side, shoulders go up about that much, down that far, out about that much, rotate at the shoulders, single bend at the elbow, rotation at the elbow, rotation at the wrist. Skirt piece is a softer plastic, just like the turtles, so you can kick forward about that much, back very, very far, can do the splits, very nice, rotates in there a little bit, single bend at the knee, rotation at the knee, and then no, ankle joints, so those are pretty static. So anyways, pretty cool for what you get. I actually really do like this figure quite a bit. There's actually a version of Usagi where he comes on a horse in this samurai armor, but the samurai armor is done more like in silvers and golds. That actually looks really, really cool. So the cartoon episodes for this season with Usagi haven't aired yet, so I'm not sure which episodes, which version of this armor suit is going to be more accurate to the cartoon, whether it's this one or the other one with the silver and gold that I seen with the horse. So I'm not quite sure, but overall, I absolutely love these figures. I think they're so awesome. I think if you're a big TMNT fan, you will definitely love them. Love the samurai armor. They all look really, really good. The colors just pop with the armor. Usagi looks awesome. I love that. Love their weapons. The dragon masks look killer. I think you can find them all. You would absolutely love them for your TMNT collection, and they are definitely a must get.
So for a quick size comparison, here they are standing next to a Marvel Legends Captain America figure, as well as a DCUC Batman figure. And for your TMNT comparison, here is Leonardo and Usagi standing next to their vintage counterparts. And just for fun, here they are standing next to little Lego Batbomb. So there it is, guys. My review of the Tales of the Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles Samurai Turtles with Usagi Yojimbo. Now, I really love these figures. I think Playmates did a really good job with all the sculpting work on all that samurai armor. I think they might be my favorite turtles from the modern TMNT line. I love the paint apps with all those different colors. I love the helmets with those dragon masks, make them look pretty cool. I love all the new weapons that we get, and they got really good articulation. I'm so glad we get a new Usagi figure, especially in that samurai armor. I think they all look totally awesome, and I think these make for some totally tubular action figures. So please comment, like, and subscribe. Cowabunga dudes, and stay nerdy, my friends. Peace.